Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury features two great, similar yet vastly different platforming games. First up, we have Super Mario 3D World. Super Mario 3D World originally came to Wii U in 2013 and is now available on the Switch in this new 3D World's Bowser Collection. Here you can play with up to four players. You can play as Mario, Luigi, Princess Peach, and Toad, setting out to rescue these fairies from Bowser. Super Mario 3D World starts out with pure Nintendo magic. This is a 7-hour long pure platformer meets collectathon. Each of the levels in each world contains 3 stars for you to find, and at least trying to look for them is necessary because of the collectathon aspect. There are roadblocks in your way that require a certain amount of stars to proceed. This can be annoying in some games, but here in 3D World the ask is pretty manageable and won't have you banging your head off of a wall trying to move on. In fact, looking for the stars really is the hook of this game, as the levels here are all super short. You're mostly dodging enemies and obstacles and collecting upgrades to help you find these stars. And for the first half of the game, I was having a lot of fun. I couldn't put the controller down. The colors, the sounds, the level design, the star finding, I was hooked. Unfortunately though, 3D Worlds doesn't do enough to consistently feel so amazing. The uniqueness and variety starts to fade the longer the game goes on. Reused assets and even reused boss battles. Super Mario 3D World feels so padded out and full of repeat content, so you don't get that feeling of excitement to see the next world or level I'm used to for Mario games. You're just hoping, man, I sure hope there's no desert or lava here. And this also leads to levels just blending. Ask me what my favorite level from 3D Worlds was. I couldn't tell you, because it's all a blur. And levels standing out really only matter in two types of games, racing and platforming. And alas, here we are with a platforming game that has levels you'll forget about in a week. Thankfully, 3D World is still fun to play through and see through to the end. There are even fun hidden levels such as Captain Toad or these challenge rooms that I just loved playing through. So even with my complaints, Super Mario 3D World proves to be a great and addictive collectathon that's hard to put down. I just would have liked to see a little more Nintendo magic and variety in the level design. Next, we have my personal favorite game in the collection, Bowser's Fury. Bowser's Fury is a 3-hour long standalone collectathon included in the Switch release of Super Mario 3D World. Here you help Bowser Jr., trying to help calm down his dad. And to do so, you'll run around these little islands, completing challenges to obtain these shiny stars. While doing so, you'll have to deal with the fury of Bowser, as he'll shoot fireballs at you. And you can play this game either solo or co-op, the second player controlling Bowser Jr. These little obstacles are fun. There are different Mario forms you can collect and change into it anytime you'd like to help you get through them and complete unique challenges. And you can even use Bowser's Fury against him by dodging and opening secret stars. Once you've obtained enough stars, you take Bowser on Godzilla style and more islands pop up for you to clear their courses. Rinse and repeat until the end of the game. Overall though, the courses in Bowser's Fury aren't anything that will blow you away, but they're the right amount of challenging, and you are intrigued to explore these areas and find all their secrets. They're just overall pretty basic, and 3 hours may seem like a short time, but I feel the game ends before it overstays its welcome. But I only feel that way because there's only 3 sections here. After the 3rd time, you're forced to go back and try to get stars on the previous islands. But you're of course welcome to go back and collect the rest of the stars that aren't needed to roll credits. But if you are after just rolling credits, Bowser's Fury is a nice little charming adventure, even though it may feel like ultimately one giant Mario level in a self-contained game. Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury is more than just another re-release. Is Bowser's Fury alone worth going out and picking up this collection? No. But if you haven't played 3D World, Bowser's Fury gives you that much more reason to add this game to your collection. I give Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury an 8.5 out of 10. If you played Super Mario 3D World plus Bowser's Fury, tell me what you thought about it down in the comment section below. If you haven't played it, tell me if you plan on picking it up. Thumbs up, like the video, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Instagram at SuperKenGaming. Thanks for watching, and of course, stay beautiful. Woohoo! You thought that video was good? Ha! You should probably watch this video, the very video that's on your screen right now that YouTube hand-selected for you. Out of all my thousands of videos, this is the one that it wants you to watch next. And make sure you're subscribed, because I'm not a genie or anything, but I'm pretty sure you get 42 years of bad luck if you made it this far into my video and you're not subscribed. You don't have to subscribe, but I'm just looking out for you. I'm just looking out for your luck and your life.